गुड इवनिंग ऑल। सो इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी स्टार्टेड डिफरेंशिएशन। वी लर्न द फॉर्मूले एंड द बेसिक प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ डिफरेंशिएशन। इन दिस क्लास वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी सम मोर मेथड्स ऑफ डिफरेंशिएशन। So before I continue, I just want to make it clear whether I am audible or not. Can you hear me? Anyone please confirm, can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
All right. Okay, so today we are going to complete this chapter DC1. There are a few methods related to differentiation. First one is logarithmic differentiation. So what exactly we do in this type, let us see. If function is of the form y equals fx to the power gx or y equals fx into gx into hx into so on, which means product of two or more functions, okay, then we take log both sides on base of e, and then we differentiate both sides with respect to x. So if you remember, there was this one type in limits 0 to the power 0. So basically, to bring the function in the power in front, we used to take log both sides and then we used to find limits. So logarithmic differentiation is nothing. It is just we take log and we bring the function in power in the product, and then we use the simple differentiation. Like for example, if y equals x to the power x, then find dy by dx. Suppose we have to solve this question. And one more thing, why we always take log on the base of e? Because in that case, we take log on the base of e because we have the formula for differentiation on base e only. Like dy dx of log x base e is 1 by x. This is the reason. So we'll start the question by taking log both sides on base e. Then after this, this will remain same. Nothing much to do here. In the right hand side, I will take the x in the power. I will take this in front. Okay. Using the property log m to the power n is l log m. Now after this I will differentiate. So this is just we say that it is logarithmic differentiation. So differentiate with respect to x, both sides obviously. Can any one of you tell me what will be the differentiation on the left hand side? I'm differentiating this with respect to x. So what do you think? What should I write on the left hand side after differentiating? Anyone?
So 1 upon y by dx.
Very good. See, actually, most of the students do this common mistake that they write the differentiation as 1 upon y. Okay. But differentiation of log y will be 1 upon y only when we are differentiating with respect to y. But here we are differentiating with respect to x. So we will use chain rule. First, we will differentiate log y. That will be 1 upon y. And then we will differentiate y. And its differentiation will be dy by dx. And in chain rule, we use multiplication sign. So 1 by y into dy by dx. Right hand side, we will use product rule. So x into log x. X into log x, use product rule. Taking x as constant, differentiate 1 by x. Sorry, differentiate log x, and taking log x as constant, differentiate x, that is 1. Finally, bring y to the right hand side. This will be 1 plus log x base e, that is ln x. And finally, I can say that dy by dx is x to the power x into 1 plus ln x. So this is the differentiation of x to the power x. Also, for objective question, remember this as a result. If it comes in board exams, you show all these steps. For objective, remember that differentiation of x to the power x is. There are many questions where we use these results directly. So it is better if we remember this particular differentiation. Overall, it is easy. Whenever we see x in power, we take log. Okay. Whenever we see a function of x in the power, we take log. Then on the right hand side, things become easy because when x or the function of x, it comes in front, I have to use simply product rule. That's it. And the left hand side, chain rule should be used. So this concept is used when we have a function in the form fx to the power gx, or we have a function which is product of two or more functions. But you can say that, sir, whenever there is a function y is equal to fx into gx, we use product rule. That is definitely right. But see, if we have a expression which is a product of four functions, okay, in that it is better to use logarithmic differentiation than product differentiation. Means what? Like, what can be the example? I will take a simple case of x plus 1. X square plus 1, x cube plus 1, or and x to the power 4 plus 1. Suppose I have to find dy by dx. Now this expression or y is a product of four functions, four brackets. So some of you can say that, sir, I will use product rule. I will take three terms as constant and then I will differentiate the fourth one. Yeah, you can do it, no problem. Like method one, product rule. So we will extend product rule here. We also call it U into V rule. Okay. So we will extend this concept. And what we do, we differentiate one bracket at a time, taking other as constant. So differentiate x plus 1. It will be 1. Write others as it is. So you have basically differentiated the first one. Now plus. Take first, third, and fourth as constant. And then you differentiate the second one, which is 2x. Then you take constant the first bracket, second bracket, fourth bracket, and you differentiate the third bracket, which is 3x square. And finally, you take the first three as constant and then you differentiate the fourth one, which will give you 4x cube. This is one way, right? This is one way to do the differentiation. But what we can do, we can opt for logarithmic differentiation also. And what exactly we are going to do? We are going to take log both sides. So I am writing ln y. And if you remember, okay, let me write this. Next step, we are going to use property of into. You remember log m into n? That is log m plus n. Similarly, if we have so many logs, if we have so many terms which are in product form and whose log is taken, so what you can do? You can write them as a sum of separate logs. This is property. So now you can write it like this. And now obviously you can differentiate. It is easy to differentiate both sides with respect to x. LHS, you have 1 by y dy by dx. Let us differentiate. Ln x plus 1 is this. Differentiation of second part, 1 upon x square plus 1 into 2x. Then differentiation of third one will be 1 upon x cube plus 1 into 3x square. Differentiation of the last one will be 1 upon x to the power 4 into 4x cube. And now finally you'll shift this y to the RHS. So dy by dx is equal to, you have this y, right? What is y? Y is this. Sorry, this was dy by dx. I forgot to write dy by dx. Because when I'm using product rule, that means I'm differentiating. So LHS, actually I forgot to write dy by dx in method one. So right side it is differentiation. Left side also it should be dy by dx. Okay, so now in the second method, we will shift y to the RHS. And what is y? Y is this whole expression, okay? Y is this whole expression. So let me write it here. Y is x plus 1 square cube 4 into this whole expression, 1 upon x plus 1. Now some of you may be thinking, are both of these same? Method 1, method 2, yes. Just multiply each with this bracket and ultimately you will get the same result as in the previous method, okay? So generally what happens, whenever there is product of more functions, normally logarithmic differentiation is used, right? You multiply this thing with every bracket here, you will get the same result as in method one. So generally what I'm saying, generally people use logarithmic differentiation rather than product rule, okay? And option will also give you an idea that you have to use product rule or logarithmic differentiation. But mainly, when you have to use logarithmic differentiation, either when the function is of the form fx to the power gx or it is the product of two or more functions, this you have to remember. This is called logarithmic differentiation. So first method is over. Okay, then after this, there is this small topic, like these are some concepts are like one-liners. So differentiation of a function, differentiation of a function with respect to another function, with respect to another function. So let me tell you what will be asked in the question. Okay, suppose I'm writing it like this. You know what is the meaning of this? I'm writing d of fx upon d of gx. So if I try to read it in mathematical terms, I will read it like this. It is differentiation of fx with respect to gx. See, what is the meaning of dy by dx? Dy by dx means differentiation of y with respect to x. Okay, this is dy by dx. So similarly, what is dfx upon dgx? It is differentiation of fx with respect to gx. All right. So now if we have to find this result, basically we will have to write their individual differentiations. How? Just remember this formula. Just remember this formula. D of fx upon d of gx. If we have to find this, just a moment. Okay, so I was saying if we have to find differentiation of fx with respect to gx, so what I will do, I will find differentiation of fx with respect to x and differentiation of gx with respect to x, and then I will write their results like this. What is d of fx upon dx? It is f dash x. What is d of gx upon dx? It is g dash x. So what we do, if we have to find differentiation of one function with respect to another,
First of all, I divide numerator and denominator by dx, and as a result, in the numerator, I will get differentiation of fx with respect to x, which is called f dash x. In the denominator, I will get differentiation of gx with respect to x, which is called g dash x. So overall, what you have to remember, d of fx upon d of gx is equal to f dash x upon g dash x. You have to remember this result. Let me take an example here. Differentiate e to the power sine x. Okay, just try to solve this and tell me what you are getting, because I have already written the result here. So differentiate e to the power sine x with respect to sine x. Tell me what you are getting anyway. Yes, anyone? What is differentiation of e to the power sine x? Yes, can you repeat?
E to the power sine x.
E to the power sine x. This is absolutely correct. See? I have fx as e to the power sine x. I have gx as sine x. I have to find d of fx upon d of gx. That is equivalent to f dash x upon g dash x. So let me write differentiation of numerator. E to the power sine x. You know that differentiation of e to the power x is e to the power x. So I will first write it as e to the power sine x, and then afterwards I will use chain rule and write differentiation of sine x, which is cos x. Similarly, in the denominator, I will write differentiation of sine x, which is cos x. As a result, this gets cancelled and the final value is e to the power sine x. Okay, let us take one more example. Differentiate tan inverse x with respect to sine inverse x. D of tan inverse x upon d of sine inverse x. So as we are proceeding in the previous example, we can write it as d of tan inverse x with respect to x, that is d by dx of tan inverse x, and similarly in the denominator d by dx of sine inverse x. And I hope you have learned the formulae. So in the numerator it will be 1 upon 1 plus x square, in the denominator it will be 1 upon under root 1 minus x square. Overall, the result will be root of 1 minus x square upon 1 plus x square. So this is also very simple, okay? Nothing much to discuss, just a basic formula, use it here. Then we have differentiation of implicit function. Differentiation of implicit function. Let us see what is this. See, if a function in x and y is such that, x and y cannot be separated. This line is main. cannot be separated, then such a function is called implicit function. Okay, such a function is called implicit function. And to differentiate such functions, we use chain rule. Just remember this. And to differentiate such functions, we use chain rule. So mainly, all this language was to just tell you what is the meaning of implicit function. So if there is a function written in such a way that you cannot separate x and y, okay, that like you are not able to write y completely in terms of x, like for example, y is equal to x square plus 3x. So it is very easy to understand that every term of x is on right hand side and y is present on LHS. So in this sense, x and y are separated. But sometimes there are some equations in which you are not able to separate x and y, and they will ask you to find dy by dx. Okay. So in such cases, what we will do, we will use chain rule. And chain rule means basically we will differentiating every term right there only. Wherever it is present, we will differentiate it simply. Like for example, if x cube plus 3xy plus y cube equals to, suppose we have this kind of equation. Okay. And if I ask you that, can you express y explicitly in terms of x? Or can I write it in such a way that y is there on the LHS and everything in x is on RHS? It is not possible here. Okay. Such type of functions or such type of equations are called implicit equations. Now, what is the question? They want you to find, then find dy by dx. I want to tell you one important thing here. Such questions, in such questions, since you are not able to separate x and y from the question itself, as a result, dy by dx will come in terms of x and y both. Okay. It will not be happening that like y is completely coming in terms of x. It will be a combination of x and y. Let us see how. So if this is 2 and we have to find dy by dx, so let us differentiate both sides with respect to x. So I was saying something called chain rule, right? Differentiate both sides with respect to x. So what about first term? Since I'm differentiating with respect to x, so first term will obviously be 3x square. Let us differentiate the middle term. 3 is like constant, so we differentiate x into y. Taking x as constant, we differentiate y. Taking y as constant, we differentiate x. Then we differentiate y cube. So differentiation of y cube is 3y square into, we differentiate y, which is dy by dx, and the right hand side it is 0. Now we just need to simplify it. So we divide every term by 3. We have divided every term by 3, right? Now, from the second and fourth term, we will take dy by dx common. So x plus y square dy by dx. This is present on LHS. On the right hand side, it is minus of x square plus y. So now dy by dx is minus of x square plus y upon x plus y square. I was saying something like this, that since the original equation is not in terms completely, y is not completely in terms of x, or it is not possible to do so. As a result, dy by dx will also be a combination of terms of x and y. But overall, see, basically it is differentiation only. Even if I don't tell you that this is something called implicit function, or this is something called logarithmic differentiation, still you will be able to differentiate it. Because if like function is in power and you want to differentiate, then obviously without bringing it in front or in product form, you won't be able to differentiate it. So it is very natural to take log, right? Similarly, we are learning the formulae in which we are differentiating with respect to x. But now if someone asks that differentiate 10x with respect to sine x, so we will think that such type of formula is not given to us. So because of that, we divide numerator and denominator by dx, all right? And it becomes the general formula or the standard formula. Same here. If I'm not able to express y in terms of x, I have to differentiate. It is asked in the question. I will start using the basic properties, okay? And here, since it is plus everywhere, okay? So you know that whenever there is plus, like fx plus gx, and I have to differentiate it. So what we do? we differentiate them separately, and if plus was there in between, it will remain plus only. Or else if it is into, we use product tool. If it is in division form, we use quotient tools. And if it is a mix, then we have to use chain rule also. Okay, so all the basic properties are being used, just names are given to it. So suppose if I have a question like this. Let us start with the easier one. Suppose I have something like this. Can you tell me what is dy by dx? Can you try this question and tell me what will be the value or the expression for dy by dx? See, what is the first thing that we need to do here? Can anyone tell me what should be the first step? How to differentiate it, how to start? Anyone? Okay, can you tell me what is this? What is this thing? The term that I am circling, what is this? What you can write in place of this? Sorry?
Why?
Yes, correct. So it is based on that concept only. You might have solved some of the equations, especially in quadratic equation, it used to come such type of question, find the value of root 6 plus root 6 plus root 6, something like that. And I think in sometimes in physics also, in questions containing circuits or something like this, such type of series are formed. Anyways, but it is very easy to understand. Like, see, y is equal to root x plus root x and it goes to infinity. So even if I start this series from here, ultimately it will be y only. Why? Because y is such type of pattern having infinite terms. So even if I left one, what will it make any difference? No. So if it is y, then here also it is y. Now what we will do naturally is squaring both sides. Such type of questions are asked frequently in board exams also. Squaring both sides. Okay. Because they generally ask questions which are related to proving something. Prove that dy by dx is equal to this much. So we will see what type of result is coming. So when we square, we get something like this. Okay. If I'm not getting y completely in terms of x because it is quadratic but x is also coming, then no problem. You have to find dy by dx. Just do differentiation with respect to x. First of all, I will differentiate this term. So this is y square, differentiation of y square will be 2y, and differentiation of y will be dy by dx. Next, it will be again dy by dx, and this will be 1. Finally, take dy by dx common. So what happened? It may be a coincidence, okay? You cannot say that, sir, see, this is completely coming in terms of y or completely in terms of x. It is just a coincidence. Usually, such type of questions are a combination of x and y. But here, if it is coming in terms of y, it is perfectly all right, no problem. Okay. So generally, they ask this question, if y is equal to root x plus root x and so on, then prove that dy by dx is equal to 1 upon 2y minus 1. Or there can be a similar question like y is equal to root of x plus root of x plus root of x and so on. Then also same concept. So all these infinite series, basically, they are solved by implicit differentiation of implicit function. Sometimes they give you a question like this. So what is this basically? This is x to the power x to the power x to the power x and it goes on. And you have to find dy by dx. So likewise in the previous example, what you will do? You will write it like this. Okay. Now it is actually a combination of two. Implicit as well as logarithmic. Because see if this y is combination of x to the power x to the power x, then what is this? This is also y, okay? So you will write y here. But now the next problem is that y is in the power. Variable is in the power. So you will have to take log both sides naturally on the base of e. Because formulae are there on the base e only. That's why. So now I will write it like this. Okay. Since I have to find dy by dx, so obviously differentiate with respect to x. And here we go. In the left hand side, it is 1 by y into dy by dx. See, I am doing it, I think, for the third or fourth time. So by now, you might have understood what is chain rule. All right. Regarding right hand side, if we differentiate, taking y as constant, we differentiate log x with respect to x. Taking log x as constant, we differentiate y with respect to x, that is dy by dx. Okay. Using product rule, keeping in mind the chain rule. All right. So now nothing is left, just basic shifting is there. So in the left hand side, coefficient of dy by dx is 1 by y. Coefficient of dy by dx is log x on RHS, just shift it to left hand side. This is dy by dx. Here it is y by x. Okay. So that's it. Just take the LCM and write it in the form that you get dy by dx on the LHS. In the right hand side, it will be y square. Here it will be x, and then this part 1 minus y log x. So I hope this is clear. Question can be a mix of implicit as well as logarithmic. It will be an obvious step. You need not to learn anything, okay? That when I have to do implicit differentiation, when I have to take log, you will come to know yourself. Because if something is in the power, especially if it is a variable, not a constant, x to the power 5, no one takes log. But 5 to the power x square plus 3x and something like that, or maybe x to the power sine x, then definitely you will have to take log. So this was everything about implicit differentiation. So till now we have covered logarithmic, then differentiation of one function with respect to another, then implicit. One more is there, which is parametric differentiation. Parametric differentiation. So what is there? Sometimes x and y are not given in form y is equal to fx, are not given in form of y is equal to fx. Instead, they are connected to each other by a third variable. Instead, they are connected to each other. They are connected to each other by means of another variable, by means of another variable or parameter, okay, by means of another variable parameter. In such cases, say t, okay, parameter say t, like, I will show you how, x is a function of ft. This is the meaning that x is a function of t and y is a function of t, but it is some other function. So basically, x and y are not directly related to each other in this form, but they are related to each other with the help of a third parameter. So in such cases, if you have to find dy by dx, okay, if you have to find dy by dx, then it is something like this, dy by dt upon dx by dt. So it looks like it is comparable to that differentiation of a function with respect to another function, because to find dy by dx, we are basically finding dy by dt upon dx by dt. So it looks like that we have divided numerator and denominator by dt. Now what is dy by dt? Dy by dt is differentiation of gt. What is dx by dt? It is differentiation of ft, obviously with respect to t. In such type of questions, you will get answers in terms of parameter only here. Like for example, if x equals at square and y equals 280, where t is parameter, that means a is constant. Where t is parameter, then t is constant. Then a is constant, obviously, okay. Then find dy by dx. Before you start solving this question, I want to ask one thing. Do you remember such thing, x is equal to at square, y is equal to 280? Have you read it anywhere? Do you remember? What is this? X at square, y 280. What is this? Where have you learned this thing? Anyone? This is parametric form of what? You might have studied. Yes, yes, please.
Circle.
No, see, in circle it used to be a cos theta, a sin theta. There we used to have theta as a parameter, right? Point used to move on a circle. Theta used to be a parameter. It used to be between 0 to 2 pi. It is parametric form of parabola. Remember, y square is equal to 4ax. There, if you put x as 80 square and y as 280, it will be satisfied. Though it is not much important here, but at least we should know what is parameter and what does it resemble. Anyways, here we want to find dy by dx. Okay, so it is simple. So what I want to say, though x and y are not directly given in terms of each other, but indirectly. How? Y is related to t. X is related to t, that means y and x are related to each other. So let us do this. What is dy by dt? Dy by dt is 2a. What is dx by dt? Dx by dt is a into differentiation of t square 2at. Okay. Question is over. What is dy by dx? Dy by dx is dy by dt upon dx by dt. So dy by dt is 2a, dx by dt is 2at. Answer is 1 by t. So I told you that such type of questions, since they are connected by means of a parameter, so that is why answer will be coming in terms of parameter only. Here they have clearly mentioned that t is parameter, and you know that you have to find dy by dx. So if someone asks what is a here, then a is obviously constant, okay? Okay, one more thing. Like here we have given this answer dy by dx is 1 by t. Now you know what happens. Sometimes in the answer you may see that no option is given in terms of t. And then you may be confused. That I told you that answer will be coming in terms of t only, in terms of parameter. But here there is no t. Like four options, they may give you four options and t may not be there. That is because of the relation given in the question itself. See. I can do one thing, I can put value of t. How? I can put value of t from here. And in place of t, I can write y by 2a. So if in place of t, I write y by 2a here, then 1 upon y by 2a will become 2a by y. Okay. So likewise, you have to be careful. You should have a good observation also. If they ask you to prove something, then you know what exactly you have to do. If it is option based question, then you have to interpret the result, that you have to write it in terms of t or y or x or combination of both. Sometimes it may be expressed as a combination of both also. How? Like y is 280, y is 280, x is 80 square, so you can divide it, okay? You can divide it, this will be cancelled. So y by x is 2 by t and y upon 2x is 1 by t. So this also you can put here and it can be a combination of both. Or it can be expressed completely in terms of x only. All this will depend on the option, okay? You can't say that I will express in terms of t only, or I can express it in terms of y only. It just depends on the question. Okay, so let us solve one question. You try this. X equals a cos cube theta and y equals a sin cube theta. Then find dy by dx. Dy by dx, where theta is parameter. Tell me what you are getting. Theta is Yes, anyone? What you will do, you have to find dy by dx. Dy by, this time parameter is theta, so you will divide it by theta. Now dy by dx is actually dy by d theta upon dx by d theta. Dy by d theta, this a is constant, you are differentiating y with respect to theta, so differentiation of sine cube is 3 sine square and differentiation of sine is cos. Okay, remember chain rule. Now differentiation of x with respect to theta, a is constant, differentiation of cos cube is 3 cos square and differentiation of cos is minus sine theta. That's it, you just simplify it. This will be cancelled, 3 will be cancelled and I think you are going to get minus 10 theta. Sine square upon sine will be sine, cos is there in the numerator, in the denominator it is cos square, so it will become cos and overall minus. Finally, the value will be minus 10 theta, the value of dy by dx. So all these are various techniques, all these are various techniques to find first derivative or dy by dx or differentiation. I hope I am clear. So as I said, now this was everything related to first derivative. The last topic related to this chapter is higher order derivatives. Higher order derivatives means, see, till now you have differentiated everything just for the first time, but you can differentiate more also. That will depend on the nature. Like sometimes you will see this statement in the question that function is twice differentiable. Twice differentiable means that differentiability holds for fx as well as f dash x. That means you can differentiate fx, why? Because it is differentiable. You can differentiate f dash x also, why? Because it is also differentiable. So that is why they say twice differentiable, thrice differentiable, etc. So we have this notation d2y by dx square. What is the meaning of this? See, what is the meaning of this notation? The meaning of this notation is that I am differentiating dy by dx once again. So basically, it is two times differentiation of y. From y, first you will get dy by dx and then you will again differentiate and you will get d2y by dx square. This notation is sometimes written like this, f double dash x, that means two times differentiation. Sometimes you will see like this also. Okay, so all these are different notations. If you differentiate something for three times, we write it like this, d cube y by dx cube. Though we read it like d cube, there's nothing like cube, okay? This is just the number to show that how many times y has been differentiated with respect to x. How many times? Three times. So what is this? This is one more time differentiation of d2y by dx square. And what is that? This is d by dx of dy by dx. I hope you are getting it, okay? So it is like this. So this is not important. This is fine, okay? This is also okay. Do not write it again and again. Or you can write it dash three times, or it is much easier to write y three. Sometimes you will find such type of notation also. All of them represent same things, okay? So likewise, if this is written, this means nth order derivative. Nth order means what? Order means that the number of times y has been differentiated with respect to x. So dny by dxn means the differentiation of y has been done n times, okay? So this can be written like this also. And now it makes no sense to write so many dash and then write it here n. Okay, it is useless. So this is fine. This is also okay. So generally for higher derivatives, either we use this notation by writing 3 4, 5, etc. Or we go for this notation where some number is written in suffix with y. Okay. If suppose we have this question, y is x cube plus. Let us start with a simple question. Suppose we have this. Then find d2y by dx square. Can you solve it? Tell me what you are getting. Solve it quickly and tell me what is d2y by dx square for this function. Yes, what is the answer?
6x plus 6 minus 1.
Okay, that is okay. So if we differentiate it for the first time, this will be 3x square, differentiation of x cube, differentiation of 3x square is 6x, differentiation of sine is cos. Okay, now you have to differentiate it one more time. Actually, you have already done these things in using L'Hospital rule also, right? It is just a basic revision. This is 6x plus 6 and differentiation of cos is minus sine. Okay, so you can go on doing it, whatever is required. Okay. Okay, so I have this question. If y equals, try this one and tell me what you are getting. I will write the options also. If y equals cos inverse x, then d2y by dx square is. Now you tell me what you are getting. Equals, and the options are. A option is minus cot y plus cos x square y. B option is minus 10y. C option is minus cot y into cos x square y. Cot y. D option is minus cos x square y. Now you tell me what you are getting. See, basically, if you differentiate it for the first time. Okay, can anyone tell me what is differentiation of cos inverse x? Do you remember anything? What is differentiation of cos inverse x?
So, minus of 1 upon root of 1 minus x squared?
Yes, correct. See, those who don't know how to differentiate it, use ITF. And with the help of inverse trigonometric function, in place of cos inverse x, you can write pi by 2 minus sin inverse x because you know the differentiation of sin inverse x, okay? So in the left hand side, it is dy by dx. In the right hand side, it will be 0 and then. So this is differentiation for the first time. First, let us differentiate and then see. Now we are getting differentiation in terms of x, but they have asked the answer in terms of y, okay? So that is important. So we will see. First, we will differentiate one more time. But before that, let me write it like this so that it becomes easy for you to differentiate. I have changed this in this form. Now I have to differentiate again. So obviously chain rule will be used. First of all, this is power. So it will be differentiated like power. So So minus half will come here, and it will become 1 minus x square to the power. We will subtract 1, it becomes minus 3 by 2. Overall, it is half. And then we take this everything here in denominator. It becomes something like this, okay? So till now it is? Yes. Okay, one more thing I forgot. I have differentiated this, taking it as in the form of power function. But what about 1 minus x square? So minus 2x will also be coming, chain rule. So here also minus 2x. Now it is okay. So actually we have done the differentiation. We have completely done the differentiation. Now let us cancel 2. So it is minus x upon 1 minus x square to the power 3 by 2. But see, our answer is coming in terms of x, and they want us to write or get the answer in terms of y. So what we are going to do, we are going to use this thing, okay? We are going to use this thing, y is cos inverse x. And if y is cos inverse x, so what about x? X will be cos y, okay? Since y is cos inverse x, this implies x is cos y, okay? Now we'll put this value here. So d2y by dx square is minus of cos y upon 1 minus cos square y to the power 3 by 2. See, today I'll be sharing something. I will send this to ma'am first. Okay, she'll be sharing with you. There is like an assignment of 30 questions of differentiation. Okay, they're very good quality questions. All of you must try them. I'm going to discuss them on the next one. Okay. But they are very good questions. Each of you must attempt, okay? Not the regular question bank. So after that, after changing from y is equal to cos inverse x, I am writing x as cos y, and then I will put it here. Now what is required? Simplification. What about denominator? 1 minus cos square y is sin square y to the power 3 by 2. We'll cancel this. This will be sine cube y minus cos y, and sine cube can be written as sine y into sine square y. Okay, I can split it like this because the answer is in terms of cot and cosec square. What about cos y upon sine y? This is cot y. What about 1 by sine square y? It is cosec square y. See, this is it. RHS. Sorry, not RHS, just whatever option is there. Minus cot y into cos x square y. So after that we have done the differentiation. What is required? To write x in terms of y. Okay. So c will be the answer. Okay. I hope this is clear. Okay, one important thing I want to tell you, actually, I missed it there, but no issues. One, in fact, two, three points are to be discussed. One is that dy by dx and dx by dy are actually reciprocals of each other. But it is true only for first derivative. Now, do not create your own formulas. Just like dy by dx and dx by dy are reciprocal of each other, therefore d2y by dx square is equal to d2x by dy square. That means reciprocal of each other. No, this result is true only for first derivative. Let me show you. So what exactly I want to tell you, that if dx by dy is written somewhere, I can write it as 1 upon dy by dx, but not true for other derivatives. Means if I write d2x by dy square, what is this? This is differentiation of x. In fact, second differentiation of x, or two time differentiation of x with respect to y. This is not equal to 1 upon. Do not generalize the statement, okay? Or any further. Only first derivative, dx by dy and dy by dx are reciprocal of each other. Let us verify this. Take any example. Suppose I have y as x cube. Okay. I will find dy by dx. What is dy by dx? Dy by dx is 3x square. Okay.
dy dx is 3x plus. So what I am doing, I am differentiating with respect to x. Now what about next? Differentiate with respect to y. Listen carefully. Differentiate with respect to y. So what will happen? In the left hand side, I will get only 1. Not dy by dx this time. Why? I am differentiating with respect to y. What about RHS? First we differentiate x cube, 3x square. Then we differentiate x, y, chain rule, dx by dy. What do you get? You get 1 by 3x square. And what do you observe? You observe that dx by dy and dy by dx, both are coming reciprocal of each other. So it is not that we are learning something or mugging up without any reason. There is proof and there is reason for it. But for now, I have taken the example, okay? It is not just a coincidence. You can take another example also. Any function. It is true for all the functions, okay? Whichever function is differentiable, it will follow this rule that dx by dy and dy by dx are reciprocal of each other. And we use it so many times. But not true for higher derivatives. Remember this. Lastly, one important result to remember, and this will end the chapter. But most importantly is solving those questions, those 30 questions, okay? They will give you the best idea about differentiation. So, first, let me write the result. Result is a relation between, result is a relation between d2x by dy square and d2y by dx square and dy by dx. This is very, very important result. Relation between d2x by dy square and d2y by dx square and dy by dx. Okay, and remember one more thing. If you think that d2y by dx square is dy by dx whole square, stop right away. It is nothing like that. D2y by dx square means we are differentiating a function two times. Dy by dx whole square means I have differentiated the function one time and whatever expression is coming, I am squaring it. Okay, both are different. D3y by dx cube means I am differentiating y with respect to x three times. Dy by dx cube means I am differentiating function for one time and then whatever is coming, I am cubing it. Okay. So do not think that both of them are same. Both of them are totally different things. So basically the last result of the chapter. Definitely we are going to verify this. Okay. So there is any function that you can think of. For that, if you find these three derivatives, that is d2x by dy square and d2y by dx square and dy by dx whole cube, then they will follow this important relation. Okay. Okay, let's leave it here. Okay. Just this one. But let us see whether this is true or not. So I will continue with the previous example, this one, y equals x cube. Because I have already calculated dy by dx, I have already calculated dx by dy. So this will help us to get the answer quickly. So from here, I will calculate d2y by dx square. And this is coming out to be 6x, okay? I have to find this. That means I have to differentiate it again, but this time with respect to y only. This is important. Though I'm differentiating again, it is okay. But I'm differentiating with respect to y, so chain rule will be used. So you are differentiating 1 by 3 x to the power minus 2. What is this? This is 1 by 3 x to the power minus 2. Okay. You are differentiating it. Let me differentiate on the LHS. So minus 2 will come here. X to the minus 3. But this will not end. Into dx by dy will also come. Chain rule. So what you will get? Minus 2 by 3x cube into dx by dy. This you have already calculated in the previous step. That is 1 upon 3x square. So this is basically your LHS. We have to verify this result. I am finding the different expressions. Taking example of y is equal to x cube. What I got as d2x by dy square, I got minus 2 by 9 x to the power 5. Okay, so LHS I have calculated. Now I will calculate RHS. For RHS, I have already this expression.
I have dy by dx also. So let us write, let us put RHS. This is LHS, okay? So in the RHS, this is minus, then d2y by dx square is 6x, then dy by dx whole cube is 3x square whole cube. So this comes out to be 27x to the power 6, and which is minus 2 by 9x to the power 5. So what do you observe? LHS is equal to RHS. You take example of any differentiable function. It will follow this important result. You will have to use this in questions directly. You know what happened? What they will say? Let me take a very simple example. If y is equal to fx is such that, they have asked this question in exam directly, and people get confused that nothing is given. Everything is given. You just don't remember the formula. If y is equal to fx is such that d2y by dx square at 1, 2 is 3, and dy by dx at 1, 2, same point is let's say 2, then find. See, they have asked this question. Now people get confused. Where is function? How will I get these values? How will I use them? You're not supposed to have any function. You are supposed to use this result. So you put this value here in the RHS. So minus 3 upon 8, that will be the answer. You put these values here. In the numerator, it will be minus 3. Denominator 2 cube minus 3 by 8. So this is the way to solve this question. Okay, you have to remember this. So these last few points are very important. One is this reciprocal relation, which is true for first derivative but false for higher derivatives. Okay, then I told you what is the difference between d2y by dx square and doing square. Both are different things. Third is this important relation. So this completes our chapter DC1. So I'll be sending you this assignment. You'll get it today or maybe tomorrow. Solve it before the next class. That is important. Okay. I'm not taking you very fastly in this chapter. I also take class for a comparatively lesser duration, but you are supposed to practice whatever time you are saving here in the class. You are supposed to practice. That is important. Otherwise, it is of no use. Okay. So those 30 questions, give proper time at least. If you are not getting answer in the very first minute or so, at least try each question for 3 to 4 minutes. So 120 minutes for these 30 questions supposed to devote. Okay. So that's it for today. Now in the next round, it will be basically a discussion class. All the 30 questions, they will take time. Okay. They are good questions. I'm repeating again and again. But important is you solve them. Okay. So that's it for today. Thank you. Bye, everyone.
Thank you, sir.